Night terrors in children. Why are children so prone to nightmares? What to do if your child repeatedly gets nightmares? Read on to know more. Hallucinations have a hold on you. Neurologist Oliver Sacks, author of Hallucinations, describes hallucinations as psychotic hallucinations, whether visual or vocal, address you. They accuse you. They seduce you. They humiliate you. They jeer at you. You interact with them. From the physical to the psychological, Dr. Sacks says hallucinations are produced by illness, fevers, sleep deprivations, drugs, grief, traumas, and exhaustion. Physical stress actually seems to lead to psychological stress. Types of hallucinations. Dr. Sacks classifies hallucinations as visual hallucinations, auditory hallucinations, and olfactory hallucinations. The demon visitor. A classic depiction of nightmare in children or sleep paralysis is like a demon visiting. Sleep paralysis. The phenomena is also known as sleep paralysis, where children, either when falling asleep or awakening, experience a temporary inability to move. It is the transition state between the state of wakefulness and the state of rest. This can occur at the onset of sleep or upon awakening and is often associated with terrifying visions. A dream you can't act out. Sleep paralysis is believed to be a result of disrupted REM sleep that prevents children from acting out their dreams. Sleep paralysis has also been linked to disorders such as narcolepsy, migraines, anxiety disorders, and obstructive sleep apnea. Relax, no risk to health. Sleep paralysis poses no serious health risk to those that experience it, except that it can be an intensely terrifying experience. Early to bed, not always a good idea. Going to bed before the usual hour is a frequent cause of nightmares, as it either forces the child to sleep for too long or to lie awake long into the night. State of hypnosis. There is a psychological explanation for sleep paralysis. As we fall asleep, our minds enter a hypnagogic state when the sleeper's still aware mind dreams images. Some people on waking up experience a hypnopompic state where the dreaming mind is faced with stimuli from the real world. In both cases, the dreams can seem very real, taking on a vivid, hallucinatory feeling. Cultural context. In Tamil culture, nightmares are known as Amuku Pei, or the ghost that forces you down. Kashmiri mythology talks of an invisible creature known as Pasigdhar or Saya, which lives in every house and attacks you if the house has not been cleaned or if God is not worshipped in the house. Prayer is the perfect antidote. Prayer or appeal to a higher, benign force is said to be sure shot cure for avoiding nightmares from visiting us as we sleep. Prayer grants a comfort that lets one sleep peacefully. For more interesting videos, subscribe to Speaking Tree YouTube channel.